What we'd like to do is show you the impacts of what happens when you have a dry tree in your house and it would happen to catch fire, just how quickly it could cause a problem. During the holiday seasons, we love to decorate. And whether it's live trees or lights, whatever the case may be, it's very important to take a few safety steps and safety measures whenever you do that. From a tree perspective, that cut that you make on the bottom of the tree is very important because that opens up the pores in that tree and allows it to absorb water. The lights that you put on that tree, they've sat up maybe in the attic or somewhere in the basement for a whole year and haven't been used. It's important to go through those and make sure that the electric cords aren't frayed. We recommend not using extension cords, but if you have to use an extension cord, make sure it's a high quality one. We like to use candles a lot, it seems like, this time of the year. So always remember, if you're going to use a candle, keep it up out of the way so your pets can't get to it or knock it down. And before you go to bed, don't leave candles on, don't leave the lights on. Make sure those things are all taken care of.
There are some ways that you can protect yourself, your guests, and the public, and help make sure your guests get home safely from a holiday party. These include stop serving liquor towards the end of the party, remind your guests that they need to get home safe or have a designated driver. You can offer coffee, tea, or soft drinks as the evening gets on. And you can arrange a home ride for someone if they need it. Or if feasible, you can offer to have your guests stay with you if it appears that they've had too much to drink or might be too tired to drive. We all want to have a good time, whether hosting or as a guest at a party. And these are some common sense ways to help make sure that that happens.